Okay, my name is Lee Sovey. I'm here today to informally discuss Blackboard's Retention Center. If you've never attended this type of session before, these are informal. They're not meant to be full organized classes or anything like that, and I didn't approach it with that intent. Basically, today what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at Blackboard's Retention Center, where to find the Retention Center. A lot of people probably don't even know it's there or haven't clicked on that tab. How I've set up my classes. A sample of how I find students that are at risk in the course using this easy method, and take a look at the alerts that I have set up, and we'll take a very quick look at how you can set up your own rule in your course. So basically, Blackboard does have a retention center, and a lot of people are not aware of this. It's down below all those buttons we see on the left side, and if you don't really peruse Blackboard a lot, you may not come across that. So this is where we find the retention center. Once you log in your Blackboard course, you'll see your typical screen. This is one of my entry pages in a course. Over on the left side of Blackboard, you'll find a little area here that says evaluation, and below that, you'll find an item here that says retention center. Once you click on retention center, it will take you to a table like one of these, or a table, or you can go to this screen here. As you can see, in my course, I have it set up for three individual items. I'll show you at the end where you can actually add more items if you wish to. The problem is when you add too many items, it becomes overwhelming, and you have to constantly remember to go back in and check on all these items. I use this mostly early in the semester to identify students that might be at risk early on. The way our enrollment system is set up at Lakeland, a lot of the online students look for courses that are easy to get into, and since emergency management starts with E, I tend to get some students that have just picked this course at random, basically because of the alphabet sometimes. I use this as a way to either make sure they understand what they need to be doing in this course, or in some cases I find out the course is not for them because I've sent them two or three alerts and they've figured, well, this guy's keeping track of me, maybe I ought to go look for another class or try something else. And quite frankly, it sometimes does happen. In my particular course, this is the EMGT 1000 course. As you can see on the table here, I have set up for three items here. One is discussion questions for weeks 1 through 4. One is set up for last course access. And one is set up for the very first quiz. And the way Blackboard sets these up, as you can see by this column over here, it's set up by type. So discussions are set up under the grade category. Last course access is set up under course access, which makes sense, I know. And quiz one appears under a grade. And then what happens is when I go into the retention center, I see a table like this. You'll see most of the students have been taken out of here for FERPA reasons. Right now, for example, it says I have 7 students at risk. That's really not true. In my courses, I have 2 or 3 fake students that haven't accessed the course in 60 or 70 days or something like that. One of which is a fire visitor that's set up for our accreditation site visit. Another one is for a peer faculty member who I let into one of my courses because he had a student athlete that had some concerns, and I let him in a course so that both of us could work with this student to help him out this semester. So normally what you would see is in this column here would be a list of names of these students at risk, but as I said, for FERPA reasons, I've taken those names out. And then the way mine is set up right now, I'm only using 2 of the 4 areas. 1 or 2 items could appear under a grades alert, and 1 or more items could appear under access alert. I have not used the other 2 in Blackboard at this point, but there are certainly other ways you can use it. So what we're going to do is take a very quick look at a sample discussion alert. Some faculty members have discussion questions set up so they grade every single question every single week. I'm not set up that way. I post my discussion alert grades 4 questions at a time. So after the end of week 4, I post the grades for weeks 1 through 4 as one grade. 5 through 9, 5, and so on is how I have that set up. If you have a setup where you're doing this every single week, this is going to make a lot more work for you, but you know, if that's how you like your course, that's fine. So this is a sample discussion alert. And what happens is after discussions, questions 1 through 4, I have it set up so that if the student has scored a grade value below 65 for this particular item, it's going to appear in a risk table here in Blackboard. Now, there's certainly harder ways to do this. Before I learned how to use the retention center, I would have to actually look at my grade book for all these low grades, and you have to look for every single student. And that took way too much work. but it was a way to do it. The easier way to do it is to have this table set up. So this is what my rules are, and I'll show you how to set up a rule at the end of today's session. Now what happens then is this particular student up here, whose name has been removed for FERPA reasons, has a grade alert. The grade alert is found by looking at this little red circle here. What happened here is the matching risk factor is this student has scored less than 65 on discussion questions 1 through 4. In this particular case, the student had done nothing this semester, so they actually have a zero. But I have it set up so I would get this alert for anything below 65. What I do then is I click on this red dot that goes with this student's name. And then I have a choice of, do I want to email that student? I'm sorry, I skipped one slide ahead here. It's hard to see over here, but it says notify the student. So once I click on that red dot, it tells me what the criteria is here. Then I can click on notify and or I can click on monitor. I have not used the monitor feature yet, but the monitor feature is a way to bring up a table on the right side of the screen that you can't see here that you can monitor that student throughout the semester if you wish to do so. In this case, what I've done is I've got it set up where I click on notify. So once I click on this notify over here on the far right side, it may be hard to see in the video, but over here is a little blue button that says notify. It brings up a stock email. The stock email can be modified. The stock email that's used in Blackboard is a very simple email that I didn't think contained enough information. So what I have it set up in this particular one, what it says here is your grades have triggered an alert from this course. You have earned a score for the week 1 through 4 discussion questions less than 65. Please see your syllabus and or contact your instructor for details. And this then goes out to that student. And by sending this to the student, you may or may not get a response from them, or at least hopefully they're looking at their syllabus. This has worked out a couple times already where I had students that somehow signed up for this class and didn't realize it was an online course. I have no idea how they couldn't figure that out, but it has happened, and I've had a couple occasions where students have said, oh gee, I thought I was in a classroom course and I just missed the first week or whatever and didn't show up. I was going to catch up with you next week, and they realize they're in the wrong course and they withdraw. So stuff like that has happened. Now what happens then is this goes out to that student and to the instructor. So in my inbox will be an email that will be a copy of this email. So that's one sample. The next example is quiz one. Now you could certainly do this for every quiz and everything throughout the entire semester. It's going to create a lot of work for you if you decide to go that route. I figure I want to attack this problem early on in the semester, and if the student's been warned 1, 2, or 3 times at that point, if they're not going to do anything about it at that point, quite frankly, me nagging them for 14 more weeks isn't going to do any good in my mind. So, and maybe some people will feel different, but I figure if they haven't fixed the problem in the first 2 or 3 weeks, monitoring them for another 13 or 14 weeks probably isn't going to solve anything at that point. So this is a sample quiz one alert. And again, it brings up this table. Now to find what the problem is, again, names would be over here on the left side. The quiz grade alerts appear here. And then what I do is I click on that red circle again. And once I click on that red circle for that student, it's going to bring up a notify. Once I click on notify, at the bottom right here, I will get an email. Again, it's a stock message. The stock message in Blackboard is, again, very simple. What I've done is I've modified it so it says, your grades have triggered an alert from this course. Please see your quiz one score in Blackboard and or contact your instructor. And again, it gives them the option that they can look at it themselves or they can realize they got a low score. They can look at their syllabus if they wish and or they can contact me as the instructor for additional information. And again, once this email is sent, it's sent to the student and to me as the instructor. The last example I'm going to give you here is the last course access alert. And I have this set up for the first week of the semester, and it continues throughout the semester. I mean, I have a student right now that hasn't accessed a course in 76 days. It's me. It's the fake student that's in there as fire visitor. So I continue to get alerts telling me that I haven't accessed my fake student account that I use for our SAC accreditation, our courses. So this is a sample last access alert. Now this particular one is going to show up in the right column. And again, the student's names would be over here, and the access alert's going to appear over here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at fire visitor. And the risk factor here is fire visitor has not accessed this course for 7 days. The alert is set up for 6 days. So if the student hasn't accessed the course more than 6 days, this alert will show up over here. So I click on that, and this is what it's set up as for the number of days. But once I click on that, it's going to bring up the email again. And what it says in this particular case is, your access patterns have triggered an alert from this course. Please log in and contribute to this course as per your syllabus. Regular attendance is required. And again, that's modified from the Blackboard message. The stock Blackboard message is very simple. I've elected to add some details to this. Now, in this version of Blackboard, at least as far as I've found so far, I would have to go down and take a look at all of these students for access alerts. So what I do is, once I've modified that email for that one student, I copy it. And then I go to each student and cut and paste that same message to each of the students that it affects. All right, so the last thing I want to go over in this short session today is creating a new rule. Blackboard comes with some stock rules. You can also add any rules that you wish to your course as long as it's an item in your gradebook. At least that's how I've determined it. And what you do again is you go back into the retention center. If you remember, you access the retention center from down here on the left side. You go into the retention center, and over here it says customize on the top right side. Once you click on customize on the top right side, it's going to bring up your existing menu. This is my existing menu that you saw when we started today. Now, so what I want to do now is create a rule. So once I go into customize, I go over here and click and create a rule, and it brings up a drop-down box. The drop-down box brings up four general areas: course activity rule, grade rule, course access rule, or missed deadline rule. What I do is I select on what type of rule I want to create, and once I click on that, it's going to bring up everything that's listed in my gradebook. And what I do is I just scroll down my gradebook and see which item I want to add for another rule. In this particular case, I'm adding a rule for week two quiz. Maybe I've done the week one alert and I've done a couple of alerts, and maybe I still think there's some hope in this particular case. So I create a week two rule. And again, what that's going to do is trigger another alert. So once I scroll down that list, click on week two quiz and hit submit over on the right side, it's going to add that to my list. So before, you saw I only had these first three items in my retention center. Now by going through those steps, what I've done is I've added a rule for quiz two in this course. And what will happen now, and I don't have a slide in here for this, but what happened now is, had this been created, it would bring up that alert table again, and there would be a quiz two in my alerts now for any students that didn't perform well at that point. Now this was particularly set up at this point in all my online courses. It struck me a couple weeks ago that I could do this for my classroom courses too. I've not done that yet. But I think most faculty, or a substantial number of faculty, are using Blackboard as a teaching assistant now. When I have I teach political science and urban studies and some face-to-face classes. When I have a quiz or an exam on my classes, I go back to the office, I grade the quiz or exams in a reasonable amount of time, usually within hours, and I post those scores to Blackboard by the end of that day. So I could actually go into Blackboard now and set up rules for those grade items for face-to-face courses. And if a student didn't do well on a quiz or exam or whatever he did in a course, I could actually use this retention center as a way to do an early alert for those students that didn't do well in the face-to-face class. I've not done that yet, but I'm looking at doing that next semester. So that's all I have. Just very short, down and dirty, how I've used the retention center. It makes it much easier back prior to using this. If I didn't use the retention center and I wanted to look who wasn't doing well in a course, I'd have to actually open up the gradebook and have to look down every single column of the gradebook for students that I thought weren't doing well. And at that point, in the old version, you'd have to make a note on who wasn't doing well, what they weren't doing. You'd have to go in and manually add emails to all your students to try get them to do better in a course. What this retention center does it for you. As long as you have the table set up ahead of time, as long as you have all the rules set up ahead of time, you merely go into that table that I showed you at the beginning, look for those little red dots, click on those red dots, it tells you what the problem is, and you have a choice of doing two things at that point. You can modify and or notify, or I'm sorry, you can either monitor and or notify that student, whichever you want to do, or you can do both. And it just makes it so much easier to do it now than having to manually scroll down gradebook lists. This will probably be especially helpful for some of our faculty that are teaching 50, 60, or 70 students in a class. If you have an auditorium-style class where you have 100 students down in the bunker and know that you want to find out, well, what students did well on my or did not do well on my first exam, you'd have to scroll down this entire list of 100 students in your bunker-style class. This will bring up that alert for you. Another nice thing about this, though, too, that I didn't cover is you can also monitor students that are doing well. So if you want to send an attaboy or an attagirl to a student that did exceptionally well on a quiz or exam, you can also do that. I've not set it up for that yet either, but one of the rules you can set up is, well, the rule is this student did better than 90 on a quiz or exam, and you could send a message to that student saying, hey, congratulations, you're doing really well in the class, keep up the good work. So a little positive reinforcement too. And that's something I learned on one of the site visits I was on recently for IFSAC is one of the college I recently visited has a kudos system in their courses. So instead of always sending messages to students, you know, you're not doing well here, you need to do better at this, they also have a way of sending kudos in their system. And it hit me after I put this together that, well, you could do this in Blackboard too. If you have a student that gets a 95 or 100 on a quiz or exam, you could set up a rule that sets off an alert telling you to that student, and you could send the same type of emails to those students also. So that's all I have. If there's any questions, I'll be glad to answer them, and if not.
So when, this is just a technical question. If you don't record a quiz score, like in my class, you know, I'll leave it blank. If the student missed the quiz, I'll leave it blank. Sometimes they earn a zero, as sad as that sounds. If you have something marked for an alert if it's less than a certain number, does it count blank as zero, or does it count as something that hasn't been done yet?
No, I believe you have to put a zero in.
Blank. It's
yeah. Yeah, blank amounts to nothing. And the question was, if a student did not show up for a quiz or exam or other assessment in a face-to-face class, they just didn't show up, didn't take it, if what happens if you leave that column blank in your grade book? You have to enter a zero, then it would trigger the alert.
I wonder if you could use the alert like, you know, I saw there was something there about missed an assignment, if you could point it to
a course activity thing? That's what I was looking for.
Yeah, that's a possibility. I've not looked that far into it. The point was raised, maybe we could possibly set it up as a missed activity. And that's a possibility too. I have not used that column in the table yet.
I've used the deadlines, and that's come in handy. The problem is, of course, is that then that persists for the rest of the semester, and it's staring you in the face, even though it's right. You know, it was the very first assignment of the semester.
It seems to me in the old version of Blackboard, you could clear that and reset it. But the new one, you can't, right?
Yeah. One thing you did mention, it is possible to notify multiple students at once with a single email. You click the underlined number at the top of the screen in that alerts bar. If you click the red bar, it then splits out to show you how many students are at risk in each category. You click the underlined number, and then you can notify all of the students who meet that criteria.
Okay, Corey has told me that you can click on that red bar at the top and notify all students at once. I hadn't found that trick yet. I was using the retention center mostly in the old version of Blackboard, and I haven't experiment with all the new stuff in the course yet. So I've been told if you click on the red bar at the top, you can notify all students at once, which will make it a lot easier because what I've done this semester is cut and pasted the few times I've used it. So that'll make it much easier. I knew the old version of Blackboard had notify all at once, but I hadn't found how to notify it in the new version yet.
Yeah, if you had any students write you sort of saying, hey, thanks for this, I'm gonna
not that often. Not that often, but I do get the occasional student that says, thanks, yeah, I missed that, I'd like to get caught up. A couple times I truly have had students say they didn't realize they were in an online course. It's how that happened, I have no idea, but it does. And I've actually had that student drop the course and ask to be transferred to the face-to-face class.
I have an assignment due Wednesday, the first week of class I teach online, because I wanted to get in there and get started and get running right away. And I have a missed deadline alert.
Okay.
And so when I've notified the students about that missed deadline or a low grade or a non-access, I get typically one of two responses. Either one, I'm really, really sorry. I'm getting myself organized. I'm going to get in there and get it all done. I promise. Or they don't respond and they drop the course.
Right.
one or the other.
And it's, yeah, I mean, we hope the students will stay and get a good grade, but it also helps filter out the students that aren't there to do the work. Or I'll get the occasional student to say, well, gee, I didn't know there was a deadline. I thought this was an independent study and I could do it when I want to. We're getting less and less of those, but I found that especially true in the emergency management courses because FEMA has 170-some independent study courses available online that you complete your own pace. So when I first started the emergency management program, I did have issues with students saying, well, gee, I didn't know there were actual deadlines. Now, that's probably their own fault for not reading the syllabus, but it reinforced the point that, yes, there are deadlines. This is not a FEMA course that you complete when you get around to feeling like completing it. And most of those issues are now gone. Okay. Any other questions? All right. Thank you for coming.